My name is Taylor Talbot. I am 19 years old. I'm a U.S. para track and field athlete. I play the piano. I'm a member of the Church of Jesus Christ, and I'm legally blind. I was diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa when I was 8 or 9 years old. I was also diagnosed with cystoid macular edema, Leber's congenital amaurosis, cataracts, astigmatism. I pretty much won the lottery backwards. I'm not exactly sure how to compare my vision to yours because I don't remember what it's like to have normal vision. It was when I was about 2 that my eyes were struck with RP. I was in gymnastics when my parents first noticed because I was really good at the beam. I loved it, but one day I just started falling off and I couldn't stay on. I couldn't keep my balance, and it was because my depth perception was going. And then sometimes I would reach to the side of things, like I was seeing double vision, or you'd look at me and it would look like I would have a lazy eye because my right eye was really getting hit hard. In the back of the retina, there are 2 types of cells. There's rods and cones. And rods are responsible for your peripheral and night vision. All of mine are asleep. I'm also missing some of my cones. They're also not active. My vision is like looking through a drinking straw, or it's like looking through a telescope the other way. So everything's a lot smaller compared to everybody else's. It's about a 10% visual field. I don't have any peripheral or night vision at all. So if there's somebody sitting or standing next to me, I can't see them. I also have a hard time recognizing people. I can't recognize faces. Sometimes I'll be able to decipher somebody by their height or their shape, but never really by their face. I'm a little bit colorblind as well. I can't tell the difference between black, dark blue, sometimes a darker gray. So that's kind of confusing sometimes when you're picking out your outfits for the day. Sometimes I'll pick out, I don't know, a purple shirt and blue tights. And they're like, everybody's like, oh, that's Taylor. I am going blind, but it doesn't really scare me. I mean, yeah, it's gonna be hard, but I'm not necessarily scared of it. I have about 5 to 6 years left, but I'm kind of excited because this is a new adventure. Not everybody can say that they've had normal vision before, but then also know what it's like to be vision impaired and still see a little bit, and then also know what it's like to not see at all. It's like you have all these different perspectives of the world, and I'm lucky because it's from behind my blue eyes. I love music. I love to feel the vibrations when I play the piano through my hands and my feet. I think it's the closest thing to touching sound. I've been playing for 13 years now. Maybe a little more than that. I started when I was really young. I play by memory and by ear. I can sight read one individual note at a time. So if there's a chord, I can see one note in that chord. And so what I'll do is, if I'm going to sight read something, I will memorize one note at a time. I'll memorize one chord in the treble and then in the bass, and I will memorize the treble and bass measure by measure, and then I will put the hands together and I will be able to play a song completely by memory. I love all kinds of music. Pop, rock, hip hop, funk, country, classical, just everything, a little bit of everything. My favorite music to play would probably be pop music or ragtimes. I love ragtimes. I think one of my favorite pieces to play is The Entertainer by Scott Joplin or Music Box Dancer by Frank Mills. I messed up. Sometimes I like to just sit down at the piano and pick out different melodies and stuff like that. I've written a couple songs, you could say. They're not necessarily written down, but they're not complete. They're just kind of pieces of melodies and tunes that I like. Through music, I'm able to express my emotions. Sometimes after a hard day, I'll just come home and play the piano. It doesn't matter what song I play, but I will play it based on my mood. So if I had a terrible day and I'm super angry, I'm gonna come home and play very loudly and obnoxiously. I just want to get my feelings out about how my day went. Music is a language that everybody can understand. And that's why I love it so much. It's because I'm able to communicate and connect with people. The most important thing that has helped me with my sight is the Church of Jesus Christ. And it hasn't just helped me with my sight, it's helped me in life. I wouldn't be living the gospel standards and doctrines and principles if they weren't true. And because I've lived those, I don't have very many regrets. It's something that I need in this life. It's a light to the world, as well as to me. Just to know where I come from, who I am, and where I'm going. It gives you a lot of hope. And I think we all need that. Family has also helped give me hope in this life. I'm the oldest out of four, so I have three younger siblings. You can imagine how that is. I have a 16-year-old brother named Ryan. I have a 12-year-old sister named Lindsay, and my youngest brother, Tyson, he is 8. I love them so much. Sometimes they get on my nerves. Sometimes they'll burst into my room, and I don't know, do some of the most ridiculous things.
Happy Halloween, loser!
But they make me laugh, and they've encouraged me, and they've helped me so much.
I can't run like this.
Sorry, but I can't run like this.
Right now, recorded by hurdling.
My parents have also been really supportive. They've done a lot for me, more than I deserve. I'm spoiled rotten. My parents have especially helped me with track and field. They met on the track team at Southern Utah University, so I pretty much grew up on the track. I've been doing track and field ever since I could walk. It's my passion. It's how I live. I'm a sprinter. I run the 100, 200, 400. I also long jump, and I've run the 4x1 and 4x4 relays. When I was 9 years old, I went to state for the Hershey's Track and Field Games. It was at Hayward Field, so that was a pretty awesome experience to go compete at that track at such a young age. I was really good at the standing long jump, which is just an event that they have where you stand in one spot and then jump as far as you can into the long jump pit. I went all 4 years to state in the standing long jump. So my first year, I got fifth. My second year, I got first. My third year, I got third. And my final year, I was a state champion again.
How far did you jump?
Give me a high five.
No, it's not up there yet.
Well, you're just
what is it?
Yeah, that's right.
No, tell me.
How did she jump?
Good.
How far did she jump?
7.5.
I think it was my fourth year that I broke the local meet record for the standing long jump, and I jumped a 7.6. I felt pretty good that day because I worked so hard. I kept long jumping and sprinting and running track through middle school. I took a year off my eighth grade year, and then I started back up in high school. My sophomore year, I went to state and ran the para 100 and para 400, and that's kind of when I was introduced to the Paralympics. I think it was August of last year, I qualified to go to the Paralympic Junior World Championships in Nottwil, Switzerland. And I competed in the 100, the 200, and the 400. I remember my first international race. It was pouring rain, and I was getting soaked to the bone. And I just remember standing there on the line, and there were a ton of people there, and I was so nervous, and there was a cameraman, and I was like, oh goody. This is gonna be great. I actually took fourth in that race. It wasn't my best, but it was still a really cool experience. And my best event is the 200, and so I ran that the next day, and I was feeling really good. I was ready. I was like, okay, this is gonna be it. We're gonna medal today.
In lane two, T13 athlete from the United States, Taylor Talbot. There's a big round of applause from the crowd.
And I took off around the corner, and I had never gone that fast before. And I was like, I'm gonna PR, I'm gonna get a medal, and I just knew it was gonna happen.
Now motoring on the inside, Taylor Talbot of the United States.
But about 5 to 10 meters before the line, I went down. I wasn't really discouraged because I knew that I had run the fastest I had ever run in my life. And even though I had fallen, I knew I could run fast again in the next race the next day. And that race was the 400. And I don't like 400s. They're not very fun. They're uncomfortable, painful, awful, terrible, horrible, no good.
Off and racing very quickly away, Talbot of the United States in lane two.
Actually, it's probably one of the most rewarding races. I don't like 400s because I know that I'm going to try my best, and if I try my best, it's not going to be comfortable. And after I ran that 200, I knew that I was going to run the 400 tomorrow, and I was in fact going to medal. And I did. I took home the bronze, and I was super happy. I felt like I had redeemed myself. I got so much confidence out of that race, and it's helped me push through these tough workouts that I am going through right now to train for the Tokyo 2021 Paralympic Games.
20 minutes, 20 seconds for 2020.
It's always been my dream to make it to the Paralympics.
Go!
And I'm super excited.
Last time I ran it, I was like dead.
To take this challenge.
Oh my God!
You might have missed your calling. You might be a distance runner.
That's gross.
No. I'm super excited to begin this journey with everyone.
The joys of running track and field.
Right. We'll see you next time behind my blue eyes.